Hi, I'm Pia. I'm an economic researcher and I teach macroeconomics. This video is about the short-run trade-off between inflation and unemployment, more specifically, the Phillips curve and the role of expectations. In order to do so, we're going to start with the concept of unemployment as well as its main causes. Then we are going to explore the definition of inflation and its effects. Then we'll define and explore the short-run trade-off between those two variables, reflected in the Phillips curve. And finally, we will apply it to the long run, incorporating the role of expectations. With this content, you'll be able to understand how unemployment responds to changes in general prices and the influence of expectations. So let's begin. Unemployment refers to a situation where a person actively searches for employment but is unable to find work. It is measured through the unemployment rate, which is the percentage of individuals in the workforce who are seeking employment but currently without a job. There are different types of unemployment: frictional, structural, seasonal, and cyclical. Frictional unemployment occurs when people are switching from one job to another. This type of unemployment is supposed to be only temporary. Seasonal unemployment is associated, as its name says, to the changes in season which lead to an amount of people running out of jobs, such as ski instructors or ice cream vendors. Structural unemployment is a little bit more difficult to deal with since it has to do with changes in technology or a country's production structure. For example, if all supermarkets turned into smart stores without cashiers, then cashiers would be structurally unemployed due to a technological innovation. Finally, cyclical unemployment is associated with downturns in the economic cycle, such as recessions. It is in these moments when aggregate demand is depressed, production decreases, and consequently, so does employment. The biggest, most recent example was the pandemic. This led to a substantial rise in global unemployment due to the cessation of activities and the indefinite closure of offices and stores. Binding all these causes together, we may arrive at one conclusion: the unemployment rate is never zero. There are always people changing between jobs or being laid off because of a structural or seasonal change. Moving on, now let's turn to inflation. Inflation is defined by a sustained rise in the average level of prices in the economy. This means that all the goods and services, at least the ones we all consume, are getting more expensive. We all pay the same for said products. A carton of milk costs the same for either a rich person and a poor person. As a consequence, if prices are rising, poorer sectors will have a harder time purchasing the same amount of products since they use a larger proportion of their income. In other words, its impact is unequal, since it implies a general loss of purchasing power. People will consume less and demand higher wages, and producers will have higher input costs. This can turn into a recession or drop in economic activity, which is caused when the loss in consumption and investment generate a fall in the general level of output. Now, both inflation and unemployment represent great dangers in macroeconomics. Governments must try to keep both indicators as controlled as possible in order to keep sustainable levels of economic growth. In other words, low inflation and unemployment. But is that easy and possible? What is the relationship between inflation and unemployment? The Phillips curve illustrates the inverse relationship between unemployment and inflation. This is a short-run trade-off, since decline in unemployment can have immediate effects on prices. Let's analyze why. Economic growth is associated with many positive things, such as increases in consumption, investment, employment, and wages. This can generate inflation since the cost for firms will be higher. This inverse relationship is reflected on the graph, as you may see. The short-run Phillips curve is downward sloping. However, it was criticized during the 1970s, when some economists started to experience stagnant economic growth with high unemployment and high price inflation. this term was referred to as stagflation. The stagflation effect required a further analysis on this theory. Edmund Phillips and Milton Friedman led this analysis and gave this a little twist at the concept of the Phillips curve. They stated that rational employers and employees would focus primarily on real wages, or the purchasing power of money, salaries, after accounting for inflation. In other words, when workers expect prices to rise, they start demanding for higher wages in order to mitigate the impact of inflation. This turns into a spiral, since higher wages imply higher costs to employers, who eventually increase their prices and make workers ask for even higher wages, and this goes on and on. This generated a separated analysis by incorporation of the role of expectations. This logic is based on the fact that consumers and workers can adapt their behavior considering the current rates of inflation and unemployment. As you may see in the graph, the curve now turns into a vertical line, which is the long round Phillips curve. This establishes a certain unemployment rate, and it is called the natural rate of unemployment, or the non-accelerated inflation rate of unemployment. As stated by its name, this rate of unemployment is supposed to prevent inflation from escalating. If an economy is experiencing this rate of unemployment, then it would actually be in full employment, since this consists of workers structurally and frictionally unemployed. And also, there is no demand from workers to increase their real wages. The importance of the NAIRU is that it states a level of full employment for an economy and, consequently, a healthy real GDP level. Why healthy? This is because some economists arrive to the conclusion that if the unemployment rate falls below the natural rate of unemployment, then inflation will be likely to occur. With everything we've just covered, it's time for a quick exercise. The graph below shows the short round Phillips curve and the long round Phillips curve. The starting point is A, with a certain level of inflation and a certain natural rate of unemployment. Suppose that the central bank decided to increase the money supply. What does happen to inflation and unemployment in the short round? And in the long round? In the short round, inflation is supposed to increase because of the higher money supply, which lowers the value for money. As for unemployment, since there is an inverse relationship in the short run, it is supposed to decrease. The economy will arrive at point B, with unemployment reaching below the natural rate. In the long run, inflation is supposed to stay higher. However, unemployment is supposed to go back to the level established by the natural rate. This is related to the role of expectations, since workers will demand higher wages because they expect future prices to be higher. This will have a negative effect on labor supply, which will increase again the unemployment rate. The economy will now be at point C. Point C represents higher inflation with the same rate of unemployment. Which are the most common mistakes? First of all, even though the long-run Phillips curve perfection the theory behind how unemployment and inflation relate, this doesn't mean that the short-run Phillips curve has no use. In fact, it is a short-run effect that still happens in many economies. Also, even though the natural rate of unemployment refers to a level of full employment and ideal real GDP, this does not mean there are people without jobs. There is always frictional and structural unemployment. Wrapping up, we've seen in this video that in the short run, there is a trade-off between inflation and unemployment. This is illustrated with the Phillips curve, and many economists use it as a guideline for controlling monetary policy as well as the rates of employment. Because of the stagflation effect, this theory was expanded with the long-run Phillips curve. The long-run Phillips curve thus resembles a vertical line at the natural rate of unemployment. This is if expectations can adjust to changes in inflation rates. Monetary policy then simply boosts or lowers the inflation rate after market expectations have resolved themselves. So have you seen cases in which a drop in unemployment can have bad consequences for an economy? And what about expectations in the long run? Do they affect prices? I hope you have enjoyed this video. And also, if you want to learn more, feel free to explore more about the topic on Chegg.